Eye of the Storm, a Sharon McCone mystery by Marcia Muller, narrated by Laura Hicks. Chapter 1. California's Sacramento Delta is a strange and beautiful place, decades removed from both the political hustle at the state capital to the north and the glittering sophistication of the San Francisco Bay Area to its west. If you ask the average Californian about the Delta, he's likely to know little, even though it contains a tangled 1,000-mile maze of natural waterways and some of the richest agricultural land in the state. More seasoned travelers may harbor vague images of a summertime paradise of slowly drifting sloughs, islands covered with sun-ripening tomatoes and asparagus and fruit, and marinas choked with pleasure boats. But a person who knows the Delta well is aware of its less hospitable side, of rain-lashed winter nights when the floodwaters rise and the narrow levee roads are no place for the timid or the uninitiated. The Delta is a constant victim of hostile elements. Every few winters, a disastrous series of storms sweeps through it, smashing levees, inundating entire islands, and forcing hundreds of people from their homes. But come clear skies, the inhabitants, many of whom have lost everything, return to dig mud and debris out of their living rooms and start all over again. That seems to be the way with Delta folk. Some overwhelming homing instinct draws them back to the land, even though they know that in a few years the waters will rise again, and at one time the destruction may very well be total. I was finding out firsthand about the Delta's unfriendly side on this harsh February evening. What I'd principally learned was how unpredictable and ominously changeable the weather could be. I'd started from San Francisco about 3 that afternoon, fighting the early rush hour traffic up the grade to the Caldecott Tunnel and into the Contra Costa County suburbs. By the time I'd gotten beyond the worst of it and was speeding through barren hills that were green from the winter rains, the sky had taken on a high, flat overcast. But it was only a patchy gray, with no hint of an impending storm. At the town of Antioch, gateway to the Delta, a white arching bridge spanned the San Joaquin River. As I waited at the toll plaza, I checked my watch. It was already close to 4:30, and I was due at a place called Appleby Island, southeast of the little town of Walnut Grove, by dinner time. Appleby Island, on the banks of the North Fork of the Mokelumne River and Hermit's Slough. The names, like many in the Delta, had an intriguing ring, and I wished I were in better spirits, capable of letting my imagination wander and speculate about my destination. But I was feeling low, and as I started across the span, I lapsed back into a dull, automatic driving mood. From the highest point on the bridge, I could see land that was radically different from the softly rolling terrain behind me. It was flat farmland, reminiscent of the Midwest, with only the faintest suggestion of mountains on the darkening horizon. High-tension towers lined by massive cable stood in formation across the foreground. Beyond them, patches in the sky had taken on definition, some still gray, others black and backlit by an eerie white glow. The temperature had dropped sharply, and the air was crisp with ozone. I turned up the heater of my old MG, thinking about the clothes I'd thrown in the suitcase that rested on the seat beside me. Had I packed that heavy Irish fisherman's sweater? I'd laid it out on the bed, but didn't remember actually putting it in the bag. No matter. Patsy would have things I could borrow. She and I had often swapped clothes in the past. Then I thought, Patsy, God, what's been happening to her? I had to admit that I was worried about my little sister. And that in itself was strange, because of all us McCones, she was the one whom I'd always regarded as the most stable and self-sufficient. I tried to figure it out again.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.